Hello students, welcome back to our lecture. Students, we have completed our lesson number one. So right now I am saving my file as symbol and I'll save it. And students, you can see by default our flash type is .fla. So I'm going to save it, and now let's move towards our next thing. So I'll just show you quickly how to draw a symbol. So I'm taking an oval shape over here, and I'll draw a circle. And students, I'll change the color to black. Okay, so our black ball is ready. So now I want to make it as a symbol. So what I'll do is I'll select this circle, and you can just right click on it and convert to symbol, or insert and new symbol. You can just go in new symbol. So right click and convert to symbol. So you can see here we have got this name convert to symbol dialog box, and there is name. You can write your name. Right now we have a ball, so I'll write ball. And what type you want? So as I told, there are three types. One is movie clip, one is button, and another one is graphic. So we will start with graphic first. So graphic and okay. So you can see now it has been converted to symbol. And how we can see this? So go in library, and you can see there is a symbol, that is ball, and that ball is nothing but our graphic. So we have converted this into graphic. And students, you might remember that I told you how to do animation, and we took a very simple animation that time, that is of a rectangle, and that rectangle was moving from left to right. So we'll do same thing with this. Only what we are going to do right now is I'll just make this symbol a little bit shorter. So okay, and I'll take this here. Yes, okay. And I'll go right here, 25th frame, and I'll just insert a keyframe over here, and let's take it here. Okay, so right now you can see that the ball has been moving, but it is not so smooth, and for that we need to add many frames over here, and we need to insert each and every keyframe and frame to move that ball from left to right. So instead of doing this, students, as we have converted our ball into a graphic, so we can do one thing, that is we can twin it. So what is twinning? Twinning is nothing but in between. So we will put, or we will involve some images in between, which will be automatic. Like I'll right click here on the frames, I'll right click, and I'll directly go in, see here, create classic twin. So create a classic twin, and now what we will see is that our ball is been moving, so it was very smooth, right? Now what if we take this ball over here? So how will our animation be? So I'll just show you. See, it has changed its direction from left to right, and now it is going cross. So this is a very good feature of classic twin, as it makes your animation very smooth, and it is used to create animation between two frames. So one frame, This is frame number 1 and this is frame number 2. That is keyframe number 1 and keyframe number 2. So in between it is bin or there is animation. So classic thing is nothing but used to put the animation in between two keyframes. So I hope that you have understood about classic twin. Now what about shape twin, right? So for that we are taking same thing, but students, I'm going to add a layer over here. Okay, so what I'll do on layer number 3 is that I'll take another shape. Okay, let's take circle only first. And I've taken green color. So now students, what I'm going to do here, that is I'm going to put a frame and insert keyframe. Okay, so for inserting that keyframe, I'm going to just take here this and I'll right click on it and create shape twin, or you can just click here and you can create a shape twin. Now see students, you'll just see right now that there is no animation, means there is animation but it is same as classic twin, right? Like what we did here in classic twin was same. I'll take it here and you can see that it's same. But students, you didn't notice one thing, that is when we were taking classic twin, we first had to make a symbol, that is a graphic symbol, and we gave a name to it, that is ball. But here there is nothing like that. We only took a shape and we just created a shape twin, right? So this is a difference. Plus see, now there will be a use of this classic twin, that is I'll just click here and I'll change the shape of it. So you can see many dots are there. So let's do like that. Okay, so at last you'll get your image like this, right? And at first it was a circle. So let's see what happens now, as we have given here shape twin on layer number 3 and layer number 1 is classic twin. So shape twin, you can see slowly it changes its shape, which classic twin doesn't do. So this is the use of shape twin, as it will change the shape in between the keyframes. So what is the use of shape twin? It will change, or it is used to create an effect of, you can say, morphing. The word given in your textbook is morphing. And what is morphing? Like morphing is nothing but the animation style only, which will show you or describe that one shape is turning into another shape. So this is nothing but morphing. One shape, that is a green color ball, is changing into an another shape. So this is nothing but morphing, and morphing is used in shape twin and it is not used in classic twin. So you can also take another shape over here, like let's take a rectangle. I'll right click on it. Okay, rectangle. I'll take here rectangle first. Let me click here and I'll take a rectangle. We have changed our color to this color, and now what we will do is we will create here a shape twin. First of all, I'll insert here a keyframe. And you can just put an animation of it rolling also. That is like this. Let's see how it comes, and I'll just right click over here and insert a shape twin. So let's see students how it is going. You can see now difference between shaped pins and a classic pin. So we have created our animation. You can see shaped pin also and classic pin also. So I hope that you have understood about shaped pin and classic pin. Okay, so now let's delete everything from here and let's take a fresh one. So I'll just clear all the frames and I'll delete all the layers only. So I'll just delete this also layer. So we have a fresh thing over here. You can see here that we have a ball, but I don't want that right now. What we are going to learn now is an animation of text. We have seen of shapes, we have seen classic twins, we have seen shape twin. So now what we are going to do is animating text. So first of all, let's see. I'll take a text box over here and I'll write hello world. Hello world. Okay, hello world. And I'll change the color of it, I'll change the size of it, so the color should be visible to you. So I'll increase the size from here. Okay, that's perfectly fine. Okay, so hello world. And let's take it in the middle. So hello world is ready. So students, what we are going to learn is now animation. So again, we will first of all create a symbol. So new symbol, I'll just insert a new symbol. And here what we are going to take is, or what we are going to write here is, let's write world. And type should be graphic. Okay, so let's click on OK and let's see in our library, is it there? Yes, it is there. And we have over here a new symbol, that is world. And students, now what we will do is we will do the same thing, first of all classic twin and all. So insert a keyframe over here and I'll take this flash animation, sorry, hello world. Down, as I was going to change it, so I'll take it down. Now you can see that it is just coming down. And what we will do here is again we will put the shape twin, classic twin. So right click and insert or create classic twin. So what will happen? Can see that your hello world is been coming down slowly slowly and going up also slowly slowly. Okay, so now you can see that we have done with our animation also the classic twin. So now what is the difference, you'll say, right? So students, once you have created your symbols, you can take it anytime. So you can see here library is there. So I'll just delete this. I'll just delete everything. Select and delete. Okay. So now it is gone. But students, here in the library you can see there is ball. You can see that there is world. See. So whatever you want, you can just take it from here. That is, I'll just drag it from here and you can see that we have our symbol ready. I can take it here and I can also take a ball. So I'll take a ball over here. So let's take the ball here and your hello world over here. Just make it like this. So students, I was going to show you about masking, right? Masking equals hold. So the thing is that you can take it anytime from anywhere if you have created a symbol. So you will find it in library, and the library, as you can store anything, so you can just take it from library anytime you want. So I'll just go on 25th frame and I'll create an keyframe, insert keyframe, and here see, you can see that both of them are moving. At first only one was moving, but here both the symbols have been moving. So I'll just take it here and I'll right click and create classic print. So you can see however you want, it has been done. So this was animating text, and this was also your classic twin and shape twin. So students, I hope that you have understood properly about all these twins and animation, and I hope that you would find this as a very interesting subject and topic to learn about. And students, I know that this lesson is all about practicing and practical, but students, because of this pandemic we are not able to do anything, but I hope that whenever we get time or whenever we our school reopens, you'll be able to do this, and trust me, you'll have very fun while doing this. And it is also very useful if you want to go in your animating world. If you want to go in that world, then trust me, it is very useful for you. So let's take a shape, any shape, whichever shape you want. Okay, I'll change the shape to polystar, and I'll take, okay, 5 is okay. So I'll take a polygon, just, and I'll change the color of it to yellow. Again, oh god, it's pink. Okay, yellow color, lime yellow. So let's, students, now I was showing you how to put an animation. So you have taken a layer, you have put a shape on it, an object on it, and also now what we are going to do is your animation. So you can see in file menu, we have to go in file menu, and you can see here there is import. So import to library, import video is there, import to stage is there. So what we have to click is on import to library. Now what we have to import, that we have to click. So it is just preparing. So I'll just go in music and I'll see if I have some, maybe I don't. Okay, so I can see here that I have, so I'll just click on high heels, I have that, and we will see in library. So we have this, but we don't have anything in our library. So first of all, let's just take it here. You can drop anywhere, you have dropped it, and you can see now there is a very thin line on your frame or keyframe, blank keyframe. So I'll just take it to 35 and I'll just insert a keyframe over here. So you can see here that you have got some blue lines over here. So when we will play
special effects,
no one.
Okay students, so you can just see the properties of this, your audio. Just click anywhere over your frame where your this contains audio contains, and you can directly click on properties, and you can see here there is name, there are effects. If you want some effects, you can take any effects from this. If you want to sync, that is, this will only allow you that our start sound, when it will start, when it will stop, it is have to, does it have to repeat and all. So if you want to repeat or loop, So it will keep on repeating. Like it is just, it specifies the number of times that the sound is going to be repeated. So here you can see one is there. You can do it till 99,999 times. Repeat also. So however you want, you can do the changes. And also sound, in sound you'll. So these are nothing but the properties of your sound. So this was it. So I hope that you have understood why we should, how we should take sound, and what is the use of all these properties, and of course our shape twin, classic twin, and I hope that you'll learn it properly. Okay, so students, we have completed our lesson. I know, as compared to our first lesson, our second lesson was completed very fast. That is, in one lecture only we completed everything. Students, I wanted to take everything slow. That is, I wanted you to remember all the tools. I wanted you to remember what is timeline, and wanted you to know what is libraries and all. So I took everything very slow. But now, as you know this, you can take it very fast, as it is very small thing to learn about. And please let me know if you are having any problem in any kind of topic, whichever we have learned until now. So after this, we will start with our revision. Okay, bye.